Hello. My brain is all over the place. It's morning, just woke up, had a coffee, and someone was talking about this subject in my Discord and sent a video to some to the nature of Microsoft is stealing open source code. And I was a little bit like, can you really steal open source code? And the answer is no, you really can't, because it's open. Like, it's out there for you to look at and use. That before you go nuts, I will explain some caveats of this. But in general, it's not stealing. You can get into trouble by not adhering to the license of this code. But it's not stealing. It's just that you are not following the guidelines that we want with the code. That said, the guidelines, when I mean licenses, and this is the caveat I'm going into, it depends on the license. So let's say we take a TPL software and I take it, modify it, do what it is, send it back, you know, the changes back, or don't. I could be a really, really bad boy and not sending it back. I'm just using, modifying a little bit and putting it into my software. That's technically not stealing. That's just me being a really, really bad open source citizen. Could I potentially get into problems? Maybe a little bit, but I don't think that you could, like, they would like sue you and you would go into court. If I, however, take a TPL code, put it into proprietary software, don't talk about it, don't use it, I could get into court by violating the document, the license, but not stealing the code. So we have to understand the differences. Stealing the code versus violating a license, two different things. That said, there are many licenses out there in the free world of the landscapes that actually allow you to do that. The MIT license, the BSD licenses. Some require you to give no contribution to the original author, and some only want you to mention their name. So one of the BSD licenses that I like the most, the ones that I actually use for all my things that I do when I want to code, is I can't remember if it's version 2 or 3 or whatever it is. But to the extent is, this is what you need, this is what the license is. You're free to use this code, whatever, however you want, even close it down in proprietary and use it for proprietary purposes. I'm really paraphrasing here. All you have to do is credit the original author. So if you are a company and you take my shitty code, put it into your box of amazingness, and you close it down, all you have to say is there is code in here done by the crazy lunatic called Kent. And you there's and also what's in that license is like this in most licenses, and that's this is basically why a lot of licenses have a license, being that they have a license just to tell you this. I am not responsible if things goes tits up. So if your computer starts to burst into fire and stuff like that, I'm not responsible. That's kind of the MIT license, kind of, again, paraphrasing a lot here. Do whatever the fuck you want, but we are not reliable. That's the gist of it. The BSD license, the ones that I like, there's different versions, but the one that I like is do whatever the fuck you want, credit me, and if it goes up in frames, I'm not to, you know, don't come at me. Don't expect me to replace your $1,000, $2,000 PC because you put a period where it should not be, and now it's a prick that you can throw at fucking idiots out on the lawn. So those licenses allow you to do that. Can you steal open source license? No, but you can violate a license, and some violations is bigger than others. That's the nature of open source. It's a little bit like saying, oh, I will sue you right now for breathing air. It's something that's freely available. There's no restrictions or anything to it. GPL puts some restrictions into it, granted. But you're not really stealing the code, you're violating the license. There's a difference here. And a lot of open source licenses actually allow you to do so, more than you think, or allow you to use it in ways that you may not deem as being good, you know, in proprietary software and so on and so on. If you, like I said, the BSD license, if you credit the author, or if you sometimes you have to, I think there's license out there where if you pay a fee or something like that, you can use what you can do whatever the fuck you want with the code and stuff. There's all different kind of license. So if you go on to, let's say, GitHub, GitLab, Bitbucket, and all these source repositories or source forge, don't automatically expect that every piece of software on there, because you can see the source code, is the TPL license. That kind of protect itself against being used in proprietary software. And if you do that and not giving back and closing it down, yes, you can potentially get sued to some extent. A lot of software, a lot, probably to some extent, I don't know if I would, like, I don't have data for this, so just take this as with a grain of salt. It's just an old fool spewing out his own experience with looking at the source code on GitHubs and GitLabs and Bitbuckets and what the fuck their source forwards and all that. Is that either it's 50-50 with GPL versus other licenses, or people are using other licenses more than the GPL. A lot of teaching institutes like the MIT license, or the BSD license, because they are not interested in controlling the code whatsoever. They just want to make sure that, like I said, they get credited for the work, and if things blows up in your face, then you're not coming and yelling at them. So they like the MIT license and the BSD license and licenses alike that are like that. A lot of hobby coders like that also, because it not only does it, as you as a developer, take a lot of responsibility away from you, it also takes a lot of responsibilities away from the people using your code. The GPL kind of requires works on both sides. You know, you would be bombarded with code submits and requests to put this into your code base and stuff like that, because they have to give it back to the author. And if you just put a code out there and you don't want to do anything with it anymore, you don't want to see fucking notification of, oh, I fixed this bug, here's the code, how to fix it. You don't want to see that. It's just a project you made and you put it out there, you drop and forget. You know, you drop it out there and you just forget about it. So MIT or BSD license may be better for you. So we need to understand before we go out and make claims about, are people stealing or what are they doing? You need to understand the license behind the code. And like I said, not all license on the source repositories are GPL. And they may not even be the license that the repository is made out of. So I think GitLab and GitHub is GPL. They can have They can have projects that are licensed under different codes. SourceForge is a really weird one. Not weird, but a strange one or a unique one. Because all the code there, I think it has to be open source. But that don't mean GPL. It could be MIT, it could be Creative Commons, it could be Apache, it could be BSD, 123.45, whatever the fuck they're called, as long as it's regarded as an open source license. That don't mean GPL 1.2.3. It means all of the others also, because they're regarded as open source. If we want to claim that Microsoft or other people are stealing code, look at the code. Look at the license for the code. And may look into if they actually got permission. So there's a lot of things we need to understand in this tech world before we can make blatant assumptions. And one thing I've learned is that the Linux world, they love to make assumptions without having any basis in what they're saying. They look at the cover and judge the book. So if you want to judge someone or assume something about someone, don't assume. Arm yourself with knowledge. Go research. Go figure it out. In this case, if you really want to know if Microsoft is stealing code, look at the license. Look at if they have any deal with the developers. Look at what's actually going on. I don't know. I have not looked into this. I just think it's a funny or an interesting subject to talk about. Like I said, I have not looked into if Microsoft is stealing code. They may well have done it. They may well have fucking stole code from proprietary software companies. I knew they did that in the 90s. They will steal code from proprietary projects. It's not out of the realm of possibilities. But is it open source code that they are stealing, or is it proprietary code, or are they stealing code with a license that allow them to do so? Those are the things we need to make sure that we understand before we accuse someone, even a company that has been known to do these things. We have to be armed with the right facts and data. You know, we need to be armed with knowledge. So don't assume. Gather information. See you all later. Bye bye.